Previously on Drive Hard.
I'm sorry, Mr. Sinister. Your parallel parking is terrible. You fail.
How am I supposed to drive with this? You'll regret this! You'll regret it! God damn magnet! Regret!
Wonderful, Marso. You were destined to drive.
Thank you, Miss Lena.
Next week is your final exam. You'll do great.
Let's go for a ride. Alright.
Goddamn, Lena. You're the best goddamn driver I have, but you're a goddamn loose cannon. Wreck cars I can deal with, sure, but losing another goddamn kid? Goddamn it. Give me a pen and your clipboard. If you don't find that goddamn kid, you're off the goddamn force.
Then I guess it's time for me to drive hard. Let's iron this thing out.
You'll never find him.
Where is he?
All right, 250 seconds. Let me go, you bitch.
Don't tire yourself out.
Hello, Marso.
What do you want with me, eh?
I want what you have. I know you, Marso. I know you very well. The way you brake, the way you park, the ease with which you decelerate. Impressive. Most impressive.
Who are you?
Stephen Sinister.
Stephen?
Stephen! There's no V, it's a PH! Asshole.
Why so angry, eh?
Because at 35, I don't have a driver's license. And you want to know why?
Tell me about it.
Because of this! When I was a child, the ice cream truck came through our neighborhood every day. But I was a fat little boy, and my little legs couldn't keep up with it and carry me far. So, one day I waited early on the sidewalk, waiting for the iced cream. So the truck came, and I ran my little heart out, but the truck didn't stop. Oh, it rang the bell, and it teased that fat little boy, but stop! It did not. And I reached out my hand and held on to that window. I knew what I wanted, and I had my money ready, and he wouldn't stop. And I held on still, and to this day, I am still holding on to that truck! He gave me my order, all right. He gave me a double scoop of fuck you. And so, My new plan is to get a new ice cream truck of my own and taunt fat children around the neighborhood! But you know, you can't do that without a license. And today, Miss Lena Olinger prevented that from happening. But don't worry, little Marceau. I will pass, or you will die.
Wait. You're willing to kidnap and kill somebody, but you won't drive without a license?
We need the license for the insurance. You don't know anything. Miss Lena, we will find out how truly dedicated you are to your students. Pop quiz! You are going 50 miles per hour and only have 30 feet to cover, and you don't have much time!
Tell me about it.
Try and fail me now! It's not moving!
Sir, you gotta take it out of neutral!
Fine, I'll take it out of neutral. No, magnet hand!
I'll help you.
Shift.
All right.
Shift.
It's not shifting.
Well, shift. Try.
You got to put your foot on the brake.
All right.
You got to put. Come on.
Try and fail me now. Is like the sun. It shines everywhere. Step into my office, please. And your things.
Not giving you your license.
Oh, but look closer, darling.
Mr. Pincus?
But why?
I had it, goddammit!
Yes! Your friend has a very weak constitution. Now, go ahead. Go ahead, over there. Now!
Mr. Pincus!
Oh, goddammit!
What the hell did you do that for? You got what you wanted!
Not yet! Not yet. You seem slow. You have gone to me every step of the way! And now I have an opportunity to kill all of you. every last one.
Surely we can talk about this.
Silence! I'm the one with the gun, not you! Well, he's the one with the gun, but I... Hola, Señor Sinister! Umberto, what is the meaning of this? I have been suckling at your teeth for too long, but this town is mine now. But you can't do this, not when we're about to take care of the biggest threat we faced. That's just it, amigo. You are our biggest threat. Your only solution is killing people. But I for one, have much bigger things in store. You won't get away with this. Of course we will. I have a gun.
Please?
We won't kill you. But, you have to trade your empire for your life. Deal?
Or no deal?
Now get the hell out of here! Ah, the driving instructor. I have heard so much about you.
Who are you?
I am Umberto Gonzalez, but you may call me the Pooh Bandit.
What do you want with us, eh?
Really? You guys aren't the least bit curious as to why I am called the Pooh Bandit?
No.
I'm
kind of drifting out over here, everybody.
Nothing. Nothing? Really? Not the least bit curious. Origin story or not? No, just moving on.
No.
All right, moving on. Whereas Stefan simply wanted to kill you, I have something much bigger in store. Especially for you, little Marceau.
Oh, hamburgers.
Grab him!
Hey, it's
being
let go.
Kidnapped!
Lena.
Again? God damn it!
All right, Umberto. Now we're gonna make a deal. Your man for mine. You've got 10 seconds to figure that out! Before he gets a little tired.
Oh, I don't think you'll be doing that. Not when you see who's the man behind the mask. Who's the man behind the mask? 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 The very same. Your former lover, whose disappearance has haunted you, has now come back to bring you doom. Eat shit and die! Eat shit and die. It was supposed to be my thing. We're going to say eat shit and die, and then you would take out the gun and shoot. You know, because the eat shit sort of sets it up, and then the shitting of the pants, and... Do you not have a gun? That was really cool. Good for you. Anyway. Eat shit and die!
No!
I'm the worst. I'm right along. Singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just told the parson, hey, Pa, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm going to fall. And I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm...
But it should call 911 or something, goddammit.
That was Les! My ex from 7 years ago, he disappeared! I don't know what they did to him, but I'm gonna find out.
Listen to me, Lena. You can't touch this guy, goddammit. Just run.
And let the Pooh Bandit win? Who are you, Mr. Pincus?
I'm a goddamn driving instructor, Lena. I could have been more. I could have been a dancer. Then I started smoking. Then I became a Zamboni driver. I could do a figure eight in a bathtub, goddammit. Now I'm just a driving instructor. Laying here with a bullet in my gut like a bum in the gutter. God damn it. Oh, god damn it.
Driving instructor's all I am too. But I'm gonna find Marceau. I'm not gonna let anybody else get hurt. Guess it's time for me.
Bienvenidos, Marceau.
Where am I?
You are at the birthplace of a revolution. It all began when I was a lonely sperm, Hunger Game fighting my potential brothers and sisters through my mother's fallopian tube before I punched through her egg and planted my genetic code. I became president of the uterus, and I soon will become president of this city. Allow me to introduce you to my generals. Piglet. Tigger. Intern Craig. It's a work study from North American University. Don't judge. And of course, Eeyore.
Oh my gosh.
Ah, damn it. That's like the fourth one this month. You guys, I thought we talked about the barracks being a safe zone. Talk about family troubles. Keep that shit at home.
What do you want with me, eh?
What's that? You asked why I am called the Pooh Bandit?
No, I just asked if...
I would love to tell you. When I was a young boy, growing up in Caracas, my mom had a jar that she labeled honey. But inside the jar was not honey, it was money. And she kept it on top of the fridge. Now, we knew what was inside the jar. But one day, this bear came, and he looked at it, and he read honey. So he reached in, and he ate all the honey. But guess what? It was not honey. What was it? Money! Exactly. So you know what I did? I followed that bear for 4 days and 3 nights. And I waited outside of a den until he went to sleep. Then I crawled in, and I cut off his fucking head with a Mach 3 turbo razor. That took a goddamn long time because there are safety precautions built into the head of that razor. And I took his head, and I put it on my head. And I walked out of the den, and I looked back, and I saw his little cub crying. And you know what I did? I flipped the cub off because they don't have fingers for middle finger flipping. I took the bear head, and I went to town, and I robbed a bank. And I became known as the Pooh Bandit. And everybody in town began to tell my story, telling kids to be responsible with their honey, because if they don't, the Pooh Bandit will surely come. Of course, I was not aware of the alternative meaning of Pooh in North America until I immigrated here in my mid-20s, but I stand firm on being the Pooh Bandit.
So what does all of this have to do with me?
Shh! Soon, I will become Pooh King!
You're lying, Umberto. You think you can point guns and push people around? It's just downright lousy.
Oh, shucks!
That kind of vinegar won't catch many flies. Perhaps you should try some honey. This honey has been infused with strands of a proprietary blend of mind control substances. One lick of these, and all the people of the world will be under my spell.
You're lying.
Believe it! What do you think keeps my generals under my thumb?
What do you want with me, eh?
You're a smart boy, Marceau. You should have figured it out by now. This is Sani Honey, the largest honey conglomerate in the world. Amongst the biggest movers and shakers of the new millennium. Practically a superpower all of its own.
Dad.
Papa.
Yes, your father. President and CEO. It's simple. Either he distributes my new blend of mind control honey to the masses, or we turn your brain into alphabet cereal. Now, Marceau, you have two choices. You can either choose to take the honey by yourself, or I can shoot you and make sweet love to your corpse until the sun comes back up.
Are you sure? This will be quicker. I mean, last chance. You still haven't swallowed.
All right. I will.
Shit, if you're going to sit there, just put some money in the hand or something. You've come to finish me off, eh? Do it. Do it right now. Bye! I've got
come
nothing.
To offer you a job. We are going to finish off the Pooh Bandit, you and me. Tag team style. Oh, gross, not that!
What makes you think you can take on the Pooh Bandit by yourself?
Got to you, didn't I?
Well, if it wasn't for Umberto and the stupid ex-boyfriend of yours, you would have been one bullet away of being shot to death.
You keep telling yourself that. You and you out.
If we do this, I want my driver's license.
Are you gonna take over the world, boss?
Yes, Piglet. Now nothing can stop us. Oh, General Marceau! How are things going, General Marceau?
Wonderfully, Master. My father assures me your wishes have been granted.
Do you hear that, Piglet? Normally you think it would take weeks or months to completely cycle through the current stock of honey in North American grocery stores. But luckily for narrative and evil purposes, it happened within 120 minutes. Marceau, do us a favor. Fetch uno, dos, tres, three of the crispest, coldest frescas from the mini fridge. Kinda cute, huh? Okay.
Hey, boss! The new Leo's here!
Excellent! Excellent! So, what can you bring to the table?
Well, vengeance!
Oh! You magnet-handed nincompoop! I am very impressed. But you forget, it's uno versus tres.
Actually, it's dos. We're not alone.
Oh, go check it out. Go!
Having a bad bidet.
This ends now.
Balls to that!
This is not a safe workplace.
Are you all right?
Not for long. Well, it appears we have a Mexican standoff.
Yes, it does.
Oh, bitch.
Eat, shit, and die, was it?
Yes. Yes, you remembered. See, I told you it was a good line. But no, I am not going to shoot our little heroine. I have someone very special for that. Oh.
Oh. Dreamweaver, I believe I can get.
Yes, look at him. Soak it in. You see, Stephen tried his little driver's license scheme with Les. But Les wouldn't do it. Had too much pride as a driving instructor. So Stefan wanted me to kill him. But I didn't. Compassionate heart. No, I had something much bigger in planned. Look at the new recipient of my mind control, honey. Oh, Bruce Willis is a ghost. Now this time, Les, I want you to finish her.
Les, it's me. It's Lena. It's me, Lena. Look into my eyes. You'll see what you mean to me. Look into your heart. Look into your soul. When you find me there, you don't have to search anymore. You can't tell me it's not worth fighting for. You can't tell me it's not worth trying for. You know it's true. Everything I do it for you. Look into your heart. You'll find there's nothing there to hide. Just take me as I am. Take my life. I'd give it all.
I would sacrifice.
Don't tell me it's not worth fighting for. I can't help it. There's nothing I want more.
You know it's true.
Everything I do, I do it for you.
I love you, Lena.
I love you, Len.
Fuck Brian Adams. Ugh. Eat shit.
And die.
What?
Hey, Umberto. Go fuck yourself. I'm rolling along. Yes, rolling along. And I'm quitting the blues of the world. I'm singing a song. Yes, singing a song. Glory, hallelujah. Just told the parson. Hey, Margaret. Maybe that should be my thing.
Looks like he's about to do a number two in reverse.
That is, Marcelo.
Hey!
Now what?
Square. For now.
So this is all could have been avoided by giving you your license.
Yeah.
I'm still not giving it to you.
I'm still king of my empire.
Need again.
Do I? Get down. I'm rolling along, and I'm quit the blues of the world. I'm singing.
Bloody mess.
Susan Whitaker, 39. She was repeatedly run over by her own car this morning. 5:15 a.m., according to the witnesses.
With her own car?
Yep, ran the plates. Neighbor said she saw the car come in, back out, come in, and out. Backed out, in, out, back in, back out. Over and over, over and over, and over.
She see the perp get out?
Negative. Said the car slammed in one last time, and that was all she wrote.
She wrote this to you?
Figure of speech.
Jesus. Didn't we find a fellow like this last week?
Yeah. John Proust, squished between his F-150 and a Silverado. Hardware store in Baker.
Like a rock.
No prints, no nothing.
He hit her mighty good. Must have hit her at breakneck speed.
That's funny.
There's nothing funny about this, mate. We'll have to look into this. Anything else?
Yeah, forensics. Found this in the car. What do you make of it?
I knew it. This is exactly the kind of slip-up that we needed. And I'll bet anything Lena Olinger is in on this. Wrap this up for me, Daniels. I've got 3 murdering mice to catch.
Will do, sir.
It's been almost a year since Lena took on Stephen Sinister and the Pooh Bandit, Umberto Gonzalez. It had started as any normal day as a driving instructor, and it ended in a bloodbath. After everything went down, they all disappeared. When the police got to the scene, there was no trace of Stephen or Umberto. I came home and found a tire iron and a badge on my doorstep. Nobody knows where Lena and Marceau ran off to. Maybe they split up, headed for the coast, to start a new life. Wherever they've gone, I hope it's far away from this rotten mess. With Stephen and Umberto still at large, no one in this town should feel safe. No one. No one.
No shite, Sherlock. Don't try to pull the wool over me eyes. That bitch Lena's just as dangerous as the rest, maybe even more so. And I'm gonna make sure she's brought to justice.
You're after the wrong person, goddammit. Lena's the best driving instructor I ever had, and that's all she ever wanted to be. It was Stephen and Umberto that put her up to this mess. They're the ones who put baby in a goddamn corner.
Well, now, gonna be in a crib. A crib with dirty sheets and a toilet with no seat. So I guess that would make her a potty trained baby, wouldn't it? And if she's potty trained, then she can be convicted of first degree murder.
You're a goddamn fool, McMurphy.
That's Detective McMurphy to you and everyone else. McMurphy O'Flannery. And I know where she's hiding. And I'm gonna find her with or without you. Now get the fuck out of me,
sir. You have no goddamn idea what you're walking into, Detective.
Oh. Honey, you scared me.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
You're up early.
Oh, I just had to get out and enjoy this early morning air. It is a beaut outside.
Oh, it is. It's so nice to get away from the chaos of the city. I don't think I'll ever get over our garbage cans not smelling like piss.
You know, I realized the other day that we've been up here almost a whole year. So I thought we could celebrate tonight. I'm gonna make you a traditional Canadian dinner. I've got French fries, gravy, cheese curds, and of course, some fresh spring water from Canada.
Occupied. Occupied. I said that. I knew this day. No. Oh, God. Oh, bear paw in my butthole. Oh, it's out. Oh, it's back in and deeper. Please, no, stop. No, no. Please, no, stop, no, oh, what, ah, oh, shit, no, oh, my feather friends, my friends, the ones I love, my beautiful pigeons, oh, here you go, Monica, Chandler Wing, where are you, here you go, where is Monica Gelfer? Where is she? Oh, there she is. Look at that.
What?
Oh, is this not good enough for you? Oh, I'm sorry. Did you have a whole honey device that was completely thwarted by that bitch, Lena Olinger? Very well. That frigid frost box will pay. I can guarantee it. Oh, what is this? Please be my father. Please be my father. Please. Really? Well, what a time capsule that is. Well, birds, it appears chapter 3 is about to turn. Monica, Ross, Rachel, Phoebe, grab me with your talons and take me to the heavens.
This is,
nice.
This is what I thank you.
This is nice.
I'm working hard. It's been a while.
It feels comfortable. You know, it takes a while to settle in, but I think you've done a good job.
I haven't even had anyone down here yet.
You haven't been murdering people?
No, not in a while.
Oh, come on.
You haven't been either, have you?
No. My hands are not bloody at the moment.
See, this whole framing business, right? Mm-hmm. This whole framing thing?
Who would benefit from setting us up, though?
Wait a minute.
What?
You know the answer.
I do?
Don't be a silly goose.
I'm not a goose or silly.
Well, tell me.
Ah.
It starts with an L, ends with a Linger.
Laura Keitinger, the first female to navigate the transatlantic ocean in a hot air balloon.
It's Lena Olinger, you dumb fuck. This is why we're not working together.
Well, not yet. But
not yet.
Soon.
Well, probably.
First
because
off, I don't think you need to be so sassy to me. I come down here, I drink your
lemon. I apologize. That's did buy you a Colombian coffee.
That's true. It is good.
It's the finest coffee in the world.
The beans are thick.
Thank you. Now, how we get Lena?
I say we take a little bowl and we fill it with jelly beans, her favorite kind. And then we take a box and we cover it.
Mm-hmm.
But then we lift the box up and put a little stick in there with a string attached. And we wait.
All right, Elmer Fudd. Now, I say that in loving, because I love Elmer Fudd, but he is a bit silly. That would take quite a while. Here's my thought. I wanted to...
Go ahead, senior.
The detective McMurphy is following her. Okay. All over her.
Okay.
So, we follow Detective McMurphy.
And then he will eventually let us know where she might be.
Absolutely, my friend. This is all going to be covered.
This is nice.
We've got it going.
Okay.
All right. Now, we just work on our communication skills, and I think you and I will make a great team, a conglomerate of sorts.
Yes.
We'll pile our assets together. And
we are a good allegiance.
I think we are.
Well, let's go get her, huh?
Here's mud in your eye.
All right. Let's go.
Let's chug. It's too hot, but don't waste it.
Just keep going. It's very good.
All right,
I will come back and finish it later.
Forget it. It'll be great.
All right, let's go.
To a year of peace.
Hear.
You know, as much as I like it here, I can't help thinking that we should have gone farther.
Farther?
Well, we are only 2 hours away from the city. They'll find us eventually. And with Stefan and Umberto still out there...
They won't find us. The police will be looking for them. Dollars to donuts.
But what if I was the only thing holding them back? I can't help but think we should have stayed, you know, just to make sure they were actually arrested.
That's not your job! You're a driving instructor, Miss Lena. It's not your job to do a policeman's job. That's
Maybe
a policeman's
right.
job.
Maybe you're right. Thank you for dinner, honey.
Anything for you, Miss Lena.
Are we still going fishing this weekend?
Sure are. I found us a guy who will rent us a boat for pennies on the dollar.
Sounds good.
This just in, breaking news here at K-Bear Jazz Radio. Murder strikes again. A woman was repeatedly run over by her own car yesterday morning. Police said it was done over and over and over and over again. Suspected behind the wheel is Umberto Gonzalez and Stephen Sinister, both of whom also suspected behind the murder of a man at a hardware store last week. Detective McMurphy O'Flannery released a statement alleging collusion between the two and Lena Olinger, a former driving instructor last seen over 1 year ago, who is suspected behind the deaths of many.
God damn it.
Oh, I got the boat. Let's go catch some trout.
I have to go.
You can't.
I can too.
Cannot.
Can so.
Can so?
Stop it, Marceau. Stefan and Umberto are killing people, and the police think I'm in on it too.
They can't get you for murder. Those henchmen didn't even have real names.
But that's not the point. They're gonna find us eventually. I need to go down there and straighten it all out before it's too late.
I guess it's too late for us then. Lena, you're gonna go down there and get arrested. And murder is the kind of thing that stays on your record for a really long time. I don't want that for you. Stay with me. I can protect you.
I don't think you can, Marceau.
That's what you think.
Did you say something?
No. Are you staying?
No. I just thought I heard you say something.
No, I didn't.
Okay. I'll just be a few days.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
Do you have anything except that sparkling water?
No.
Oh, that's okay.
See you soon. Sooner than you think.
Oh, I didn't even grab my keys. All right. Got them, bye.
Hey.
This is Lena Olinger.
What's the game, Missy? You're on top of an adjacent building waiting to pop me head off with a sniper rifle. Go ahead, you Jezebel. If you got the stones.
I'm nowhere near you, detective. Called to tell you you're looking for the wrong girl. But if you help me out of a pickle, I just might be able to punch your dance card.
So you're telling me the lass who kills more people than Scientology is innocent?
I was backed into a corner, Murph. A fighting man like you knows what that's like. You know there's only one way out, and it ain't covered in rose petals.
And what about these most recent allegations? You're telling me a driving instructor doesn't have the resources to pull off vehicular manslaughter. Don't piss in me Guinness and tell me it's whiskey.
Listen, Murph, I ain't got a lot of time. So here's the skinny. You and me, 3 o'clock at Ginny's Diner. I help you catch these crooks, you lay off my tail. Deal?
Sure, I'll meet you. I'm famished.
Yeah, Murph, you need to come alone.
Oh, I work alone, Miss Olinger.
And that includes your little pea shooter. Leave your piece at home. This lunch is friends only. You won't be using it.
Younger, my bicycle didn't have a seat, just the pole, so yes, I'm accustomed to it.
So what's up with all this framing you're trying to get on?
Yes,
us,
you think
huh?
We can't be bad enough?
You're on a goddamn killing spree!
That is incorrect. We are on a goddamn friendship spree that has seen no blood at this point.
Now this friendship spree has been fun, but what say you and I go on another killing spree?
Only if we could kill somebody that looks like, if I don't know, Reba McIntyre had a leather vest and a piece.
Freeze!
Give me a fucking reason. I knew the three of you were in on it together the whole time. It was obvious.
Oh, you've got it all wrong, McMurphy. We were out to kill her.
Yes, and it would have went along swimmingly if she wouldn't have came around and messed it all up
again. I told you to come unarmed, Detective. I have nothing to do with these murders.
Oh, you've been trying to kill us since day one.
Oh, coming from the asshole who kills people just to get his driver's license.
Evan!
You laugh at fat children.
Two things. First off, he is a former fat kid, and sometimes laughter helps ease the tears. And secondly, you contemptuous little puta, I would spit on you if I had moisture for mouth spitting.
I get to make fat children jokes. I was a fat child. I get to make fat children
Absolutely.
Jokes. You don't get to make fat children jokes.
How do you know if I was fat or not as a child?
Because it's just the way you carry yourself.
Uh-huh.
Former fat girls are seemingly more empathic, and you just come off a little frigid. Now, I don't mean that personally, but that's just sort of my observation in the last couple of days.
You are a bit of an ice queen.
Yes.
Bit. Because I was a fat child, that's why, that's the whole crux of the situation. I was a fat child, you can't make fat jokes.
Hey, shut the hell up, the lot of you, before I mace you all.
You don't
want
all
right,
to
we make... got. Hey, we gotta stop. We gotta help this citizen right here.
You gonna mace him too?
We gotta, shut the hell up. What seems to be the trouble with the car, mate?
No trouble at all, Detective. Just lacks a few passengers. I'll be handling the investigation from here on out, McMurphy.
Over my dead body, fella. These lot are mine, and I'll bring them to justice.
So be it.
Umberto, no.
Hey, sweet Jesus!
Relieved of your duties, Detective.
Kiss me, Royal Irish arse!
Marceau, no!
Get out!
Oh, a white carjacker! This is interesting! I've seen one of these before.
Alright, alright!
Are you gonna leave us here?
Hey, hey, what the fuck is going on?
I told you I would protect you. I'm sorry I even let you get close to those two cretins.
No, this is not the Marceau I know. The Marceau I know doesn't kill people when I get kidnapped. It's like the exact opposite.
I told them I was gonna get revenge on them. One day. Today is that day.
Woohoo!
Almost missed!
Blast! Out of range!
It was Marceau all this time.
Who would have fucking thought?
He's moving cars with his brain!
I know!
His brain.
With his mind! I mean, that shit is Lolo!
Lolo.
Yes, Lolo.
I don't know this Lolo.
Well, instead of cray cray, using crazy, I'm using loco to say Lolo.
Oh, great. Great. What do we do?
So what I'm thinking is we have a strong, aggressive social media push. Use it in blog posts, Twitter entries.
No. Marceau, what do we do about the Marceau situation?
Yes. I say we do what we were meant to do.
Uh-huh.
I say we take our shirts and we button them to the top.
Yes.
And then we pull our boots up. We walk up to him and we say, touché, and then we walk home. Go our separate ways.
Oh, my goodness, we can't run the rest of our lives. It's gonna be constant. He'll find us.
I don't have any cars in Caracas, just sand and Corona bottles.
Right, but if we do this instead, we go after Marceau before he can get after us.
Yes, but if Marceau killed a detective. If we kill a guy who killed a detective, then we're killing a bad guy. We're the bad guys.
Does that make us good guys then? Wait. Wait a minute.
What?
Because after we kill him, we'll be killing Lena. That makes us bad guys again.
That bitch,
a good guy,
of course.
Girl.
Oh, yes. That will make us the bad guys again.
We have a plan.
We have a plan. But also, what about right now?
We've been waiting for the spy for 15 minutes.
Too many 15 minutes.
You have some explaining to do.
Okay. It was about a year ago when I discovered my powers. Years of perfect driving, kept me in tune with the motor vehicle. I could see it at once as everything and nothing. I could soothe every sputter, calm down any rumble. But most importantly, I could turn the engine on with my mind.
Why didn't you ever say anything?
I was scared of what you'd think of me. And why shouldn't I be? I've always been scared. All those times that I got kidnapped, held powerless by those ne'er-do-wells. But as my powers grew, I thought I was the one that could be in power.
You killed all those people, didn't you?
I had to teach Stephen and Umberto a lesson. They could hide from the police, but they couldn't hide from me. I had to break a few skulls to make an omelet, but it'll be worth it.
That's awful.
Is it? Do you know what those people did with their lives? Susan Whitaker ran red lights all the time. As if we are the only ones that have to stop. And John Prust, you'd have to put a gun to his head to make sure he'd turn his lights on in a thunderstorm. When are people gonna get it that it's not about you being able to see, but for other people to see you? He was a threat to society, but no longer because of me.
So what are you gonna do, just kill all the bad drivers out there?
Admit it, it's something you've always wanted to do yourself. Every missed turn signal, every stop sign roll through, every pumping the brakes when all you gotta do is let off the gas a little bit. All of them up for termination. Think of it as a social Darwinism, but with cars. Only the strong survive.
I do hate those people. But no, the world can't work like that. It's barbaric. Why don't we just stay here, you know, where it's peaceful and we don't have to deal with any of that?
Have you seen how fast people go down that road? I mean, come on, there are kids in the front lawn playing, for Pete's sake.
Marceau, do it for me. Please. I know. You could use your powers for good instead of evil. Killing people is totes evil. And I know. I also have blood on my hands, but I am trying to wash them clean. And I can't do that when yours are all red and sticky.
Perhaps you're right. I guess I did get a little carried away.
Yeah.
It's hard not to when you have superpowers.
I bet.
Let's get some sleep. We'll talk about it in the morning.
Yeah, I could use that.
I've actually got something for that.
Oh, thank you. Is this sleepy time tea? It tastes kind of weird.
Oh, well, that's because I added a little something extra. Starting tomorrow, there's a new king of the road.
You know, there's not a lot of songs that talk about the material of afterbirth in their song and still reach the top 40s. Need a driver, cause you wanna drive a car up here. Need a only driver, cars with mass appeal. God, I love the thrill of the hunt.
It's the chase, really. It's the journey.
I cannot wait to take down that guy.
You can make an arrival, but it's getting there. Mm-hmm. The thrill, the weight, the anticipation. I had way too much coffee. Though. Your civic leadership knows how to drive. Driving harder than before is what we know is drive. Hey,
Let's go, bitch.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Glory, he has risen.
Glory, he is coming again. Rap-da-da, rap-da-da. Going.
What did Sam help? They're back for more, eh? Out of range again.
Killing bad guys.
And that makes us the better guys.
Too bad. I've got the baddest of them all.
Biodiversity of the prairie.
Come on.
No, I want to feed the bugs.
We have to finish this. Think about the code of honor.
I'm sorry. I forgot car snacks. And I wish I had some Mr. Freezes. Because we could store them in that frost box. What the fuck?
Take whatever you got.
Yeah, what do you have?
No!
Killing me.
My skull.
We need to get out of here, Sinister.
Where is here?
Gentlemen, this couldn't have worked out better for me. I was going to let you both get arrested and hauled away to the slammer, but instead, you've made me improvise. I thought about running over the car, but shooting you just seemed so much easier.
Yes, and shooting us seems very unoriginal.
Well, I'm gonna do it like 50 times, so I'd shut my bazoo if I were you. Or as it was you. It doesn't matter. The point is you're going to die at the hands of Marceau. So, let's give it a shot.
Ugh.
Pun intended.
Do it.
Anything to say to our enemies one last time, Miss Lena?
Yes. Umberto.
Yes.
She didn't die.
I don't even use that anymore.
Stefan.
What?
Why don't you try grabbing my tire iron now?
What? That's a catchphrase.
I said, try grabbing my tire iron now.
Well, you could go to the library and pick up a book with one line.
Oh my god, use your fucking magnet hand and grab my tire iron.
Before, and I'll say it again. Fuck Brian Adams.
I'm sorry, Marcel.
So, let's all get mojitos.
Oh, stop. Yes, please. Sounds good. I'll meet you guys there.
We could really use a lift.
This handcuff thing is really a...
You are always going to be that little fat kid.
And that was that. Lena took off, and no one knows where she went. Probably out west to start anew, maybe as a driver's ed teacher under a new name. I never heard from her again. I sincerely hope she turned out okay. Maybe Stefan and Umberto got pinched that day, but I know the charges won't stick. They'll be on the street in no time. I've seen a lot of goddamn things in my life, but they all pale in comparison to this crazy goddamn adventure. We lived fast, we killed young, and we sure as hell drove hard.
That's it, goddammit.
Yeah.